From among all the prophets, Muhammad was the last, as his was a mission of the greatest task. There was only moral degeneration. People clung to idol adoration.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, صلى الله وسلم وبارك على عبده ورسوله الأمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أبو بكر الصديق, a man who is as big as a mountain, not in size but in his strong and firm belief in Allah and in his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Ibn Umar narrated, may Allah be pleased with him, and this was reported in Sahih al-Bukhari, that at the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, we used to prefer Abu Bakr, then Umar, then Uthman, may Allah be pleased with them all. Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, was among the most knowledgeable people at the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And his knowledge was displayed clearly when the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, at the end of his life, gave a speech. And he talked to the companions while they were gathering at the masjid. And he said that a servant of Allah was given the choice between enjoying this life or choosing what Allah has stored for him. And this servant of Allah chose what Allah has saved for him. And Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, started weeping and crying. And he came to the Prophet ﷺ and said, we give our lives to you, O Prophet of Allah. And the companions were astonished. What is wrong with this old man? The Prophet is talking ﷺ about a servant of Allah who was given the choice, and he is saying what he's saying, and he's weeping and crying. And after a while, after the Prophet ﷺ passed away, they realized and recognized Abu Bakr to be the most knowledgeable one, because he knew that the one who was addressed with this choice was the Prophet himself sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Because of his knowledge and because of his belief and faith, the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam chose him to lead the people in prayer when he fell sick. And Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, thought that the people would think badly about Abu Bakr if he came in the place of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So she told and requested the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam by saying, O Prophet of Allah, Abu Bakr is a soft man. If he recites the Quran, he would weep and cry. But ask Umar. Umar is a strong person. Let him lead the people in prayer. And he did not pay any attention to what she said. She asked him again, and the Prophet ﷺ neglected that. She asked him a third time, and then the Prophet said ﷺ, instruct and order Abu Bakr to lead the prayer. You are like the women who were accompanying Prophet Yusuf, peace be upon him, who made the things happen to him. The people would not allow anyone except Abu Bakr, and Allah the Almighty would not allow anyone to lead the prayer except Abu Bakr. And this shows us that his status is not to be neglected. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam instructed us to follow his sunnah, the sunnah of Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him. And that is why the Prophet said alayhi salatu wasalam, follow the sunnah of Abu Bakr and the sunnah of Umar. He was the first rightly guided caliph among the companions of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and they called him the Caliph of the Prophet, which means the successor or the representative of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. He was not given the title of a ruler or a king. He was the successor or the follower or the representative of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. And the Bukhari also reported that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, before he died, he requested and instructed them to bring him a piece of paper and pen so that he would instruct people to take Abu Bakr as his successor, so that people would not wish or say otherwise, because Allah only accepts Abu Bakr, and so would the people. Also in another hadith, to highlight the status and the position of Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, a woman came to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and she spoke with him about something we do not know of. And then he instructed her with an instruction. So the woman said to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, O Prophet of Allah, what happens if I come later on and I would not find you? So what would I do with the things you've instructed me to do? So the Prophet said alayhi salatu wasalam, if you did not find me, go to Abu Bakr. If you do not find me, because I died, then go to Abu Bakr, which means that he is the successor of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And this hadith was reported by al-Bukhari and Muslim in the Sahih. Abu Bakr was close to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, but it's not necessary to be close to someone and be at the same time the most beloved one to that someone. You can work closely with someone but have no cordial relationships, have no feelings towards him. It's just work, it's just business. With Abu Bakr, it was not like this at all. He was the most beloved person on earth to the heart of our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Amr ibn al-As, may Allah be pleased with him, was one of the most smart and intelligent people of Arabia. And he plotted a lot against Islam. Yet, on the 8th year of Hijrah, Khalid ibn al-Walid and Amr ibn al-As, a little bit before that, they accepted Islam. And he tells us, being one of the most intelligent and cunning people on earth, he said that whenever I went to see the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he used to smile in my face. And at the beginning, I was so afraid of him, I could not look him in the eyes. But then, as it became frequent, that is my visitations, and I noticed that whenever I come, he smiles to me and he welcomes me. So I thought that probably I have this position and status with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam that I'm not aware of, but I can understand and see that by the way he's treating me, I'm different. So he says, I approached him one day, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and said, O Prophet of Allah, who among all of your companions you love most? And he was expecting the answer to be you, Amr ibn al-As. So the Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam, in answering his question, he said, Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her. So he said, I did not mean among the women, O Prophet of Allah. I meant who among the men is your most beloved companion. And again, he was anticipating and waiting to the answer to be you. But the Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam, clearly without any doubt, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, may Allah be pleased with him. And this hadith was reported by Imam Muslim in the Sahih. This was the status of Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, with our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. We have a short break, so stay tuned.
Muhammad, peace be upon Muhammad, peace be upon his soul.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah and welcome back. Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, was described in the Sunnah in so many hadiths that the minute you read them, you realize what caliber of a man he was. May Allah be pleased with him. The Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam, none of you all, and he's addressing his companions, none of you made us a favor that we did not reward him for it. Which means that every single companion was rewarded for any favor he did for the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. But there was an exception. The Prophet said, none of you gave or made us a favor and we did not reward him, except Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him. He made us and he gave us, that is the Prophet alayhi salam, lots and lots of favors, and Allah the Almighty will reward him for it on the Day of Judgment. And by Allah, no wealth or money of any of you had benefited me more than the money of Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him. And if I were to have a best friend among the livings, I would have had Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him. But I am the best friend of Allah, the Almighty. And this is the word Khalil. And Khalil mean something more than a friend, something who is close to someone. And this was given only to two messengers of Allah, Ibrahim, peace be upon him, Abraham, the prophet of Allah, the messenger of Allah, he is known to be Khalilur Rahman, and to our prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was also known to be the Khalil Ar-Rahman, or the best friend of Allah. Abu Bakr was always told that he is in paradise. So while he was walking on the earth, he knew his destination, and he had received so many glad tidings from our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, who does not speak in vain. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, whatever he says, this is a revelation, so it is true. And whatever he prophesizes, this is a reality without any doubt. And that is why the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, in one incident, said that whoever spends, whoever gives away at the side of Allah two pairs of something, Allah Azza wa Jal will call him from the gates of paradise. And paradise has gates. And we know that paradise has gates. We know that hell has gates as well. But we know that the number of the gates of hell are seven, as mentioned in the Quran, while the number of the gates of paradise are eight. So the Prophet goes on to say, alayhi salatu wasalam, therefore, whoever is known to be a worshipper in forms of prayer, he would be called from the gate of prayer. And if he's a worshipper in fasting, he would be called from the door or the gate of fasting, which is known as ar-rayyan. And if he is from the people who give charity, he will be called from the charity gate. And if he is from the people who struggle and do jihad and they fight in the cause of Allah, they will be called from this gate of jihad. So Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, said, well, these beautiful gates, O Prophet of Allah, I see no harm if a person is called from all of them. Meaning that if a person is doing all these good deeds, then he will be called from not one, from all of these eight gates, so that he could enter from any gate he pleases. And is there any harm in someone being called from all of these gates, O Prophet of Allah? And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, no, and I hope and wish that you will be one of them. And this is a glad tiding, that Abu Bakr will be called from all of these eight gates. And one would say, Can this be? Is this possible that one man be called from all these beautiful and glorious eight gates? Can one person have all of these good and great attributes in him to be a person praying, fasting, giving charity, offering jihad, doing this, doing that, to be called from all of these eight gates? Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. And definitely Abu Bakr is the best candidate to assume this position. Why is that? Well, it was reported in the Sahih, and the hadith was narrated by Abu Hurairah, may Allah be pleased with him. He said that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, after praying Fajr, and we know that Fajr is the dawn prayer, which is before sunrise. So after praying in congregation with his companions, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, addressed his companions and said, who among you is fasting today? So Abu Bakr raised his hand and said, I am fasting, O Prophet of Allah. Then question number two, who among you followed a funeral? And this is an Islamic tradition that once you pray the funeral prayer over a dead person, you carry him on the shoulders and you take him to the graveyard. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is asking, who followed a funeral until it was buried? Again, Abu Bakr said, I did, O Prophet of Allah. Now imagine, this is at dawn. So he had to have done these things like 2 or 3 hours earlier, which meant that he did not sleep. And the companions did rarely sleep because they used to spend all their nights doing and offering night prayers. Then comes the third question, where the Prophet says, السلام, who among you fed a poor person? And again, Abu Bakr raised his hand and said, I did, O Prophet of Allah. And finally, the fourth question, who among you had visited a sick person? And as you expect, Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, raised his hand and said, I did, O Prophet of Allah. These four attributes, these four actions were done before sunrise. The Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam, by Allah, any person who does these four things in a day, Allah Azza wa Jal will make him enter paradise. And this was the habit of Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him. So, with all these glad tidings, one would expect that his head was big, thinking of himself that I am second to none. I am Abu Bakr. I'm the one who Allah gave me all of these glad tidings and I'll be in paradise. I am the one who the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said that the first one from my followers to enter paradise is Abu Bakr, which means that all the prophets of Allah will enter paradise and the first one behind them would be Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him. If I were in his shoes, I would have boasted about it a lot. I would be proud and talk to everyone and look down at everyone, but not Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him. You are talking about the wrong guy. Abu Bakr was not like this at all, may Allah be pleased with him. And that is why our righteous predecessors, whenever they talked about Abu Bakr, they said that he did not have an extra edge over the other companions, except with something in his heart. And this is quite true. He was not the best among them to pray night prayers, like Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, for example, who used to pray the whole night, all night long. He was not among those who used to fast a lot or used to do things that others would not follow him. He did a lot of great things, but it was not his actions that gave him this status only. It was the belief in his heart. May Allah be pleased with him. And that is why he would always be humble to whom, whatever he was, really. May Allah be pleased with him. He was not deceived by the praising the people say about him. You are among the best of the companions. You are the closest to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You have the honor of the Prophet marrying your daughter. So you, in a sense, you are the father-in-law of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. He was not fooled by all of this. And that is why when he went to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and he said, Oh Prophet of Allah, teach me words that I could supplicate during my prayer. The Prophet did not tell him, alayhi salam, say, Oh Allah, increase my wealth, or increase my health, or prolong my life, or bless my children. The Prophet did not instruct him to do this. Now this request is coming from the best to walk the earth after the prophets and messengers of Allah. He's the best companion. And listen to what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told him to say. He told him to say, Allahumma inni zalamtu nafsi zulman kathira. وَإِنَّهُ لَا يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ فَاغْفِرْ لِي مَغْفِرَةً مِنْ عِنْدِكَ وَارْحَمْنِي إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Which translates to, O Allah, indeed, I have wronged myself greatly, and there is none who forgives sins besides you. So, grant me forgiveness from you, and have mercy on me, for you are the all-forgiving and the most merciful. Look at these beautiful words. Words that bring whoever is flying in the sky down to earth. Whoever thinks greatly of himself to remember, to be humble, to remember that he's sinful. And these beautiful words were taught to Abu Bakr. May Allah be pleased with him. The best of the companions of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And he was instructed to say them in prayer, to supplicate to Allah Azza wa Jal in seeking Allah's forgiveness. Now, if this is the case with the companion of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, Abu Bakr, how would you think that we should feel? And what are the words that we should supplicate to Allah Azza wa Jal? One of us, after performing Umrah, thinks that he had reached the heavens and he believes that whatever he does is, alhamdulillah, Allah will forgive because I performed the Umrah. One of us, after praying Taraweeh prayer one night for half an hour or 45 minutes, goes back to the house and turns on things that he's not allowed to see and watch, or listens to things that he's not allowed to hear or listen to. And when he is questioned about this, he says, I just prayed night prayer. Who among the Muslims did this? We look up to ourselves and think greatly of them while they are nothing but dirt. Look at Abu Bakr, look at his status, and look at the supplication. I've wronged myself. And this is Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, the best of the companions of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. This is all the time we have for today. Until we meet next time, fi amanillah. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
محمد, peace be upon his soul. The greatest of prophets, Islam was his only goal. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. From among all the prophets, Muhammad.